raised up in this ministry to be a prophet.
Yes.
He got baptized, filled with the Holy Spirit around 8 or 9 years old.
Yes.
On a visit from Birmingham. And my husband called him up and he was looking around, and it was the first time that he had ever been to a spirit-filled church. My husband called him up, and the moment that he laid hands on him, he fell out under the power of the Holy Ghost and began to speak in tongues. And he told us, he said, "I want to get baptized in water."
Struggle breaker is definitely in the room. And God, I just heard the Lord say that many have been struggling and you've been going in cycles. And in fact, the enemy has even been eating up your blessings. But I hear the Spirit of the Lord say that the struggle breaker is in the room, and that I've come to break the cycles. Cycles. He said, in fact, if you would just submit today, I'll move upon your submission. So if you just have a heart and you ready to get received, just open your heart up, because God is in fact going to move today on your behalf. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I give honor to God. I give honor to my natural mom and even my spiritual parents, my leaders. I give honor to them, because I truly don't know where I would be without you all. And so I honor you all, and I love y'all.
We love you, too.
Amen.
Amen.
So I'm just going to pray, and then we can go right into the word that God has given me Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you and I praise you and I honor you. And I lift you up in this place. I lift you up. And I thank you for what you're about to do. And I submit to you. I yield totally to you, Holy Spirit, that you would take over me. Take over me now, that you may speak through me, that you may walk through me, and that you may even talk directly through me, that I may be dead in you, that you may stand tall and move in the name of Jesus. And so I yield to you. I yield my eyes, my ears, my mind, my will, my thoughts, my emotions to you in the name of Jesus. I yield it totally to you, and I thank you for what you're about to do. And I even thank you for your word that's about to go forth, that it may go forth with fire, that it may burn up the enemy, and that it may even release people into their end times, and that it may even release them right at their blessing in the name of Jesus. And so I thank you now that the blesser is in the room, and that your blessing is here and now in the name of Jesus. And so I thank you and I honor you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In fact, for the past couple of weeks, God has had me on a almost like a series of being obedient. And I just been in this series, and he began to speak to me, and he said many are in fact coming to church, and they're claiming that I'm their God. And he said, but how can I be their God and they haven't come in contact with true obedience?
Yes.
And so he took me, and I was laying on my floor, and he just began to deal with me on obedience. And he says that there's a great thing that I desire to do in the lives of even the young people. He said, but I first must teach you obedience and how to be obedient and what is the opposite of obedience. And we all know that the opposite of obedience is disobedience.
Yeah.
And that is a spirit that has been running rapid in this day and age, is the spirit of disobedience.
Yeah.
And so God began to deal with me, and he said, every part of disobedience that's been lying on the inside of you, I want you to get rid of it.
Amen.
And so I just began to say, God, I don't want disobedience. And I began to say, Father, wash me and take every seed of disobedience out of me, because I don't want it.
Yeah.
And so he moved upon it, and he brought it out, and then he began to plant the seed of obedience on the inside.
Amen.
And so God has had me on this series of obedience and being free from disobedience.
Amen.
And so I was just in his face this week, and God said, I want you to tell the young people, but even though this is Youth Sunday, he said, tell the young people, but it also can apply to some adults.
Amen.
And he said, teach them the law and the heart of obedience.
Yes,
the law and the heart of obedience. And I want you to understand that obedience has everything to do with your blessing. And many times the enemy comes and eat up the blessing because there's a spirit of disobedience that's connected to the devourer. And the enemy wants to eat the blessing, and even the young people, he wants to destroy us and take us out by a spirit of disobedience. But God understands the law of obedience. And at the beginning, that was the very reason of the fall of man, because of disobedience. Amen. And so God wants to endow us with obedience that we can receive the blessing. But there is some blessings behind obedience.
Amen.
And so he said, teach the law and the heart of obedience. And so, if I could get somebody to read. But I'm just going to give you a definition of obedience. And obedience is to submit to one's order, requests, or authority. So, obedience is to come under one's order, authority, and request. And I even seen another definition that said to submit and come under without reasoning or questioning. And so many times we miss what God is trying to do because we always reasoning and we always gotta question what God is doing. And I hear the Lord say that do not no longer question or reason, because you've been missing your blessing while you questioning. And so God, I seen a definition, and it said to hear and act accordingly. So obedience is to submit and come under authority, is to submit and come under one's order and request, and is to act accordingly of what you heard without reasoning or questioning.
Amen.
And so when I get an order, and when God or someone in authority tells me to do something, I heard what they said, and now I process it and I move without either questioning or reasoning what's the process behind it.
Yes.
And we miss the blessing. And so God began to download. He said, I'm ready to pour out my blessing upon the people. Uh-huh. And even the young people. He said, I want to release my blessing so that they can be a blessing to others.
Uh-huh.
He said, but how can I release the blessing when there's no obedience and there's no submission and you're not acting accordingly to what I told you to do? And so, obedience is connected to the blessing of God.
Amen.
And so I want you to turn to Luke 11. 11 and verse 28. Luke 11, 28. And obedience, I seen a quote, and it in fact said that obedience is connected to the blessing, but it said, due to your level of obedience is how far you'll get in life.
Amen.
And so if you see a person that's very disobedient and they do the opposite of what they've been requested to do, I can already see your future at the end.
Wow.
Because you're disobedient.
Wow.
And disobedience will stop the flow of God, and it will cause the enemy to come eat you up.
Wow.
So not only will it stop the blessing, but it will even have a target on your back for the enemy to come knock you out.
Oh.
And so Luke 11, 28.
But he said, yea, rather, blessed are they that hear the word of God and keep it.
So blessed are they that hear and keep the word of God. And so keep means, I seen in the Hebrew, keep means to shamar or watch or preserve. And so when you keep something, you keep it dear to you, and you walk, and anything that opposes that thing that you keep, and you say, nope, that's not the will of God.
Uh-huh.
Keep it moving. Nope, that's not. And so when you keep something, you keep it, and you move directly with that thing in your face, and you know that that's the thing that God or that person said, and anything that comes against that is not what's originally stated.
Amen.
And so keep is to shamar or watch or preserve, and so you're going to keep something.
Yes.
And so God said, blessed are they that keep and that keep, that hear and keep.
Hear and
that
keep
hear and keep the word.
Amen.
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 So blessed are they. And so I want you to understand that obedience has to be birthed in your heart.
Amen.
It's not a mind thing, but it's a heart issue.
Yes.
And obedience must be birthed in your heart. And so when I went to God, that was the first thing I said, Lord, let obedience be birthed in my heart. Because I don't want to be one of the ones that's walking around full of obedience in the mind, but they not acting accordingly, and they always reasoning and questioning what's been stated. And so I told God, put it in my heart, so that when it's in my heart, I can act accordingly, and I won't have to think about what you're doing.
Yes.
And so obedience has to be birthed in the heart. And so turn to 1 Samuel. We just going to move with the Holy Spirit.
Yes. Yes.
1 Samuel 16. First Samuel 16, and we're going to read verse 7.
But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, but because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth.
So God don't look at what man sees.
Yes. For man looketh on the outward appearance.
So you looking at the situation or the outer appearance, but God is looking somewhere else. So why are your eyes looking over here when God is looking over here?
But the Lord looketh on the heart.
So he's looking at your heart. And God is watching what is coming out of your heart.
Yes.
And in fact, that's the thing that God is watching over and looking at. And if obedience is not birthed in the heart of you or the individual, and you if obedience is not birthed in your heart, then you will be one of the very ones that will be fooled, and you will miss the blessing, and you will in fact be cursed, and your land will even be cursed.
Yes.
And so God began to say, it's time to be obedient, because obedience is my, it was a law since the beginning, and it was the very fall of man. It was the law in the beginning, and he said everything else is attached to your obedience.
Yes.
And the Bible even declares that obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes.
So you can be sacrificing, but if you're not obedient, then God, he'll look at you and say your sacrifice was even vain.
Yeah.
Because you're not even obedient.
Amen.
And so it's time to be obedient. So now,
yes,
I want you to understand that the blessing is God's favor and protection. The blessing of God. The blessing is God's favor and protection. And so, if you're not obedient, you won't be able to receive the favor of God, and you won't even be protected, and you'll be out of boundaries, and the enemy will be able to eat you up.
Yes.
And the heart is the seat of your personality and who you are. Your heart. So your heart has everything to do with the matter. Your heart. And that's why God looks at the heart, and he wants to see what is in your heart. What is in your heart?
Yes.
I want you to really look in your heart and see what's in your heart. Have you been obedient? Have you been moving when God tell you to move, or have you been moving at your own pace? Have you been moving when you feel like moving? Or have you been moving when you've been told to move? And do you always question a reason why you're doing something?
Talk about it.
Why? And so, we're going to turn to Hebrews. We're going to turn to Hebrews 13. And 17.
Obey them that have the rule over you.
So obey them that is over you, that is ruling over you, that has authority over you. Obey them. Why?
and submit yourselves.
So you're going to obey and you're going to submit and come under and not reason or question.
For they watch for your soul.
Because they are watching over your soul.
Yes.
So you have to be obedient and submit because they are watching over your soul.
Yes.
And they are the ones that are responsible of getting you where you need to be. Yes. But if you're not obedient, you'll go astray and miss where you need to be.
As they that must give account. That they may do it with joy.
Yes. So not only will you be benefited, but they gonna be benefited because they'll be doing it with joy.
Yes. And not with grief.
And not with grief. So the person that's over you, they have to give account for your soul.
That's right.
They are the ones that you should be obedient to and submit to because they're going to give the account and you're going to be benefited because you're going to get where you need to be and they're going to be benefited because they're going to do it with joy and
yes.
not sorrow.
Yes.
They should not have to always tell you to do something over and over and over again because it'll make them tired and then now you causing them to be grieved because you always disobedient.
Amen.
Come on now.
Well, you preaching. Man.
Preaching.
Amen. So be obedient. It's time to be obedient because God wants to take us somewhere. Even
yes.
the young people, God wants to take you somewhere. You are not to sit down and just be here, but you have a destiny and a purpose that awaits you.
Yes.
You have somewhere you need to be. But if you are disobedient, you're going to be the very ones that's going to sit down and look up 10 years along the way and say, I should have been obedient. Shoulda, coulda, woulda, but you didn't. And so now you are hurt. And so we are going to turn to Deuteronomy. The law. This is the very law.
Yes, it is.
And so we're going to turn to Deuteronomy 28. And 1. Start at 1. Amen.
And it shall come to pass.
So it's going to come to pass.
If thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So it's going to come to pass that if you hearken, which means if you listen to the voice of the Lord thy God, what's going
to
happen?
To observe and to do all the commandments which I commanded thee this day.
So you're going to listen and then you're going to do everything that God requested or commanded.
That the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations of the earth.
So God is going to set you up on high. He's going to exalt you and put you above so that you can be looked at and people can be blessed because of you.
Come on, God.
And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee.
So you're going to be blessed in the city and everywhere and they're going to overtake you.
If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
But that's only if you hearken to the voice. If you listen to the Lord and you move.
Yes.
If you don't listen and you don't move, you're going to be cursed. You're not going to be blessed.
Yes.
And you're going to miss your blessing.
Jesus.
Blessed shall thou be in the city.
So you're going to be blessed in the city.
Blessed shall thou be in the field.
You're going to be blessed in the field. Everywhere you go, going to be blessed.
Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body.
Your body going to be blessed. You won't even have to deal with sickness. Your ground going to be blessed. So now you're going to have your ground blessed and even your children can go pick out that ground.
The fruit of thy cattle.
Your cattle are going to be blessed.
The increase of thy kids.
So your kids are going to be blessed.
The flocks of thy sheep.
The flocks of your sheep.
Come on.
Blessed shall be the basket in thy store.
So your basket gonna be filled with blessings.
Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in.
When you go in, you're gonna be blessed.
When thou comest out.
And when I leave out, I'm still blessed. So I don't have to worry about what you say because I'm blessed anyhow. When I go in and when I come out.
The Lord should cause thy enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before.
enemies are even going to be removed.
Yes.
You got so many enemies, and the reason your enemies overtaking you is because you refuse to bless. And you refuse to be obedient.
Yes.
They will come against thee one way and flee before thee seven ways.
So the enemies gonna come against you this way, and then they gonna have to go the other way.
The Lord shall command the blessing upon thee in thy storehouses.
God is gonna command the blessing to come upon you.
Yes.
He's gonna command the blessing to come upon you.
It is all that thou settest thy hand unto.
And everything that you put your hand to, it's going to be blessed. So not only will you have to worry about moving to and fro and looking to get money from everywhere, because money is going to be your very portion. You can walk somewhere and touch somebody and now they bless. I can look at you and I can put my hand upon you and now you bless. And so God is even going to anoint your hands. I even see God anointing some hands. God is anointing your hands. He said if you would just be willing and obedient and submissive, I'm going to bless your hands. Heavenly young people, I see God anointing your hands, because God has blessings that you haven't even seen coming your way. But God said, be obedient and be submissive, and the blessing is your portion.
Yes.
And he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee.
So God is going to give you land, and he's going to bless that too.
The Lord shall establish thee in a holy people unto himself.
He's going to establish you amongst people.
Yes.
If thou shalt keep the commandment of the Lord thy God.
But that's only if you keep the commandments of the Lord and you're obedient.
Amen.
If you're not obedient, I'm not even talking to you.
And walk in the way. And walk in his way.
And so that's only for the people that is obedient and walk in the ways of God.
And all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord.
And so not only that, but people gonna catch your name and see you amongst other cities and nations and say, my God, how they so blessed? Why is Brother Lonzo so blessed? Why is Sister Brenda so blessed? Why are they so blessed? People gonna be able to catch y'all amongst the way, because y'all are gonna be obedient and submit to the will of God.
And they should be afraid of thee.
And they gonna even be afraid to even come near you and touch you and talk and put their mouth on you, because you gonna be so blessed. I remember Pastor told me, he said, but signifies everything before this or something like that. It's like, everything before this is canceled out. So we're going to move with this now.
But it shall come to pass.
So everything else canceled out. So now it's coming to pass.
Of
the Lord thy God. So if you do not listen to God's voice,
to observe to do all his commandments in his statutes which I command thee this day,
and look and do everything that he's commanded you to do. So if you don't listen and you don't look and you don't do what he commanded you to do,
that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Amen.
You're going to be cursed, and they going to come and they going to overtake you.
Cursed shall I be in the city.
So you're going to go in the city and you're going to be, woe is me. Woe is me.
And cursed shall I be in the field.
You're going to walk in the field and now you, woe is me. I ain't got none. Ain't never had none.
Cursed shall be thy basket in thy store.
And so your basket going to be cursed and you ain't got nothing in the basket. And so even your body gonna be cursed. So now you dealing with sickness and you dealing with disease and infirmity because you refuse to submit and be obedient.
And the fruit of thy land
and your land cursed.
And the increase of thy kin.
Your kin is even dead.
And the flocks of thy sheep.
Your flocks dead.
Come on.
And a bond that you can trust them and you can lay on them or come to them and put all your cares upon them, and they still got your back at the end of the day when everybody else turn on you.
Amen.
And so now you have the ability to be friends with God.
Amen.
That's the first blessing behind being obedient.
Yes.
And that's in John 15 and 14. And so we're going to turn to Romans 12 and 2. The second one is we get to know the will of God.
Come on.
If you're not obedient, you don't know the will of God.
Yes.
You don't even know the will of God. And so you stagnant and you moving everywhere and you looking everywhere else because you don't know the will of God.
Come on.
And you're not even in time. You moving with your own timing, and it's not the timing of God, and you done already missed 15,000 blessings. You out of place, you out of order, and so people gotta keep telling you over and over again to get in alignment and get in position. Get in alignment, get in position, because you refuse to be obedient. And so now you don't know the will of God, and so you come into church and you don't know the will for the pastors, you don't know the will for the preachers, you don't know the will for your parents, you're disobedient, they gotta keep telling you over and over again, get up, go do this, do that, do this, but you disobedient, and so now you don't know the will of God.
That's right.
Amen. Wow.
And so, Romans 12 and 2.
And be not conformed to this world.
So, be not conformed to this world.
But be transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Amen. So be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And you must do this daily. This must be a daily thing that you transform your mind and put your mind to the side and take on the mind of Christ, because in his mind you can know his will.
Yes.
The reason you don't know his will because you still got your old mind and you want to do what you want to do.
Amen.
And that was the very thing that would get you cursed. That's the very thing that caused Adam them to be deceived and cursed.
Amen.
Amen.
That you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
So now you will know the will of God because you are obedient. And it's time to be obedient. Put your will to the side.
Yes.
Put what you like to the side.
Yes.
Put your thoughts to the side.
Amen.
People are so tired of telling you over and over again to do something. Be obedient. It is time. God began to tell me that I'm ready to do a thing such in you and even the young people and even for this ministry. I'm ready to do something spectacular that people never seen before. But he said, I can't do it if there's a bunch of disobedient people. You're gonna miss the will of God and you're gonna miss your blessing. And you're gonna stay here and everybody else gonna leave.
Yes, amen.
Because it's over with. God is tired of disobedience. And he began to quicken me. He said, it's time for you to get in alignment and be obedient because I want you to know my will. I want you to get the blessing. I want you to be a blessing to others.
Amen.
But you won't if you don't know the will and if you're not obedient.
Amen.
So, amen. That's the first. Well, that's the second one. And so, the third blessing behind being obedient is you are able to bear forth fruit. You are able to bear forth fruit. The reason that you're not bearing forth fruit, I come to tell you, is because you are disobedient. You're not bearing fruit. And so we can't even see witness of why you've been in the ministry of 12 years and you're still in the same place. I can't even see why, because you're not bearing fruit and you're being disobedient. And it's time to get in alignment. And children, the reason that your parents keep telling you over and over again to do something is because you are disobedient. And so you're not bearing for fruit, and they can't even see why what they've been telling you is coming to pass, and you're still doing the same thing over and over again, and you're falling into the same stuff, and they tell you to come out, and you're going back in. It's because you are disobedient. And I come to expose disobedience so that you can be planted with the seed of obedience.
Yes, amen.
And so, most importantly, the last blessing that I have is your prayers will be answered.
Yes.
Your prayers will be answered. And so you will be able to go to God and ask him for
Amen.
A thing, and it will be answered quickly
Yes.
and immediately because you have an obedient heart.
Yes.
The reason prayers ain't going through is because you disobedient. And you wonder, you mad at God, and you mad at your parents, and you mad at everybody because you wonder why you ain't getting the things that you keep asking God for. And God is saying, nope, my hand shut up. You ain't getting nothing because you disobedient.
Wow. That's right. Amen. Come on.
Jesus. Have mercy.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
And so.
You better preach.
Come on.
And so I'm going to give you the consequences behind being disobedient.
Amen.
Disobedience. The first consequence that the Lord began to say was true transformation will not be able to take place.
Wow. Amen.
When you are disobedient, you cannot be transformed or changed.
Wow.
And so the whole will and purpose of God for us to even be on the earth was to be transformed and changed daily so that we can look like God, because really your life was just an assignment put on the earth.
Amen.
Your life is just an assignment passing through to do a will real quick.
Yeah.
Do a will real quick.
Yeah.
And so God wants to establish himself in you and through you. And God wants to do this, and he wants to establish and do this by transforming us. But transformation cannot take place if you are disobedient.
Amen.
And so you still look the same like last year. You still got the same smell like last year. And you even walking and talking the same because transformation not taking place because you disobedient. And I come to tell you that even the kids, you doing the same thing you did last year. And the reason that you can't even pray, you can't even lay before God, it's because you are being disobedient and God cannot transform you.
Amen.
And so we have so many wars in our minds, and the enemy comes and lies to the young people. I'm specifically talking to them now, because the enemy comes and lies, and he comes and plants seeds in your head and tell you things, and the reason they can't be uprooted or pulled down is because you won't get in the face of God to be transformed or changed. And you rather look at your phone and the TV and not get in the face of God. And so transformation will not be able to take place. And so you're going to look everywhere else and see everybody else doing something new, and you still doing the same thing. Same old thing. And so disobedience, you won't know the will of God. Of course, that's another one I got. And everything you touch will be cursed, and you're going to be predestined for failure.
Wow.
And the very things that you try to put your hands to are going to be cursed, and they're going to fail. And then people, many times I've seen people where everything failed for them, and then they look to God and they mad at him. And God looking at you like, what I do? I've been telling you all this time to get yourself together. And so God is telling us to get ourselves together, because there's a blessing that is on your way.
Amen.
But are you going to miss the blessing because you disobedient? Or are you going to receive it and move quickly with the speed of God and do a new thing because you're obedient? And so you're going to be predestined for failure if you choose to be disobedient. And because I just told you this today, you're going to be tried by fire. The enemy going to come try you and see if you're obedient. And are you going to pass the test, or are you going to fail it? Because you still got the same head and the mindset. And so, last but not least, one of the consequences for disobedience is God will declare he never even knew you. And so there's a lot of people that are in the church, even young people, they sit in the church and they steady hearing the word of God, and they hearing it, and they know what the will of God is. They know God told them to do right, and they know they should be doing this. They know they should put the cigarettes and the weed down. They know they need to put the drugs down. You know you need to be doing the right thing, but you steady picking it up, and you doing this and doing that because you're disobedient, and God gonna look at you and say, I don't know you. You've been in a church and you saying that you're my son and I'm your God, but I don't even know you.
You ain't.
I don't know you. That is not my character. That's not my personality. That's not the heart that I had put for.
Amen.
And so God is going to declare that he never even knew you. And that's the worst thing that you could ever get. That's the worst thing. And I want to be one of the ones that God say, I know him, because he bare for fruit. He was blessed everywhere he went.
Yes.
He had a heart of obedience.
Yes.
And he was submissive to my will, and he submitted to even the will of others.
Yes.
And he had a spirit of humility.
Yes. Yes.
And he was willing to be obedient.
Yes.
And so God wants to establish the blessing upon many of us.
Yes.
It is time for God to bless you. You've been looking everywhere else, and you've been wondering why you haven't been blessed, and it's simply because you've been disobedient. You've been disobedient, and you haven't been moving in purpose, and you haven't been moving swiftly what God has for you to do, because you refuse to be submissive, and you always reasoning and you questioning why this and why that, and God saying, why not?
Come on.
Why not? Why not do the right thing? Why not be obedient? Why not do something different while everybody else doing the same thing?
Come on.
Why not? And so God declares today,
yes,
that it is time for the blessing. It's time that we be blessed. You overdue. You are overdue, is what I hear God say. You are overdue. It is time for you to be blessed.
Amen.
It is overdue. And God says that if you are willing and you're obedient and you're submissive, he says that I'll release the blessing. And he says everywhere you go, you're going to be blessed.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus.
And so, we're going to turn to Deuteronomy 5 and 33.
Deuteronomy 5 and 33.
But before you read that, turn, hold your finger on that and turn to Ephesians 6. So we're going to read Deuteronomy, but we first going to read Ephesians 6.
Children, obey your parents in the Lord.
And so God is now talking to the children. He said, obey your parents.
For this is right.
Obey your parents in the Lord. Which means that you're going to do the will of God while being obedient to your parents.
Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise.
Honor, which means respect them. Respect your mother and your father. Honor them. Respect them. Do whatever they ask you to do. Don't reason and question why they're telling you to do it. Just be obedient. Put your head down. Put your thoughts down. Your will down and be obedient.
Amen. That it may be well with thee and thou mayest live long on the earth.
And so God says that if you are willing and obedient, yes, it's going to be well with you.
Well.
And not only is it going to be well with you, but you're going to live long on the earth. You're going to be able to experience many blessings and good things because you decided to be obedient, yes, and do what everybody else is not doing.
Amen.
I stand here today and say that I truly have been tested and tried with obedience. And I've made up in my mind that I'll be obedient when nobody else is being obedient. Because I want the blessing of God, and I don't want nothing to hinder or stop or block the flow of what God want to do in my life.
Amen.
And so be obedient, because you can live long on the earth. There's a lot of young people, they dying daily, and they being taken out because they simply didn't make up in their heart and their mind that they want to be obedient and do the right thing.
Amen.
And because of disobedience, it caused their life to be snatched quickly.
Wow.
And they leaving, and it is time for us to be obedient.
Amen.
So now we're going to read Deuteronomy 5 and 33, and then
ye shall walk in all the ways which the Lord your God hath commanded you, that ye may live, and that it may be well with you, and that ye may prolong your days in the land which ye shall possess.
So, God says that everything is going to be well with you, and that I'm going to be pleased with you, and that I'll get the glory out of your life, and that many will know that I was God and that I blessed you because you was obedient and you took care of my will first. You decided to submit anyhow, and it don't feel good to submit and just be obedient sometimes, but don't question and reasoning, but many times you have to say, mind, be still and be obedient and submit anyhow. You have to tell your mind to move out of the way, because I'm going to do the right thing and I want to receive the blessing. I don't want to be held up any longer. I don't want to be prolonged and blocked and hindered and stopped and looking everywhere for my blessing, but I want God to release my blessing right to me. It's time for the blessing. And so God began to quicken me. He said, I'm ready to release the blessing. He said, but I can't release it to a bunch of people that's disobedient and they refuse to do the right thing. It's time to get in order and be obedient. And so that's what God gave me. And I just thank God that he released that, because I want to be blessed. I don't know about you, but I want to be blessed. And this is the season to receive my blessing. I'm not waiting any longer because I'm going to be obedient. And God said that if you are obedient, the blessing is yours. And so if you're not blessed, you better check your heart and be like, you weren't obedient. You was not obedient. Because you decided to be obedient, I'm going to receive the blessing, and you are too. And there's many blessings that God looks to release to some of you. Some of you are God wants to, and God really has in mind to release it quickly. But God was just getting order around you. That's what I even hear the Lord say who you are. He says that many things were held up because I was just waiting to get order so that I can release the blessing and everybody else can be blessed in spite of. And many people have even been speaking against the blessing, but I hear the Lord say that I'm releasing the blessing, and this time when it come around, many are going to look and wonder how y'all were so blessed, because I see y'all names even being launched and pushed forward. And this is the season for the blessing. And so I'm prophesying in the name of Jesus that the blessing is moving you all's way now. That is even being dropped down now in the name of Jesus. That God is even stamping you all with blessings. That you all are stamped with approval to receive the blessing in this season in the name of Jesus. And this is the season for the blessings. And so if you one of those ones that haven't been obedient, and you've been holding up the blessing for this house, even this house, you've been holding up the blessing. And God wants you to know to remove yourself or get in alignment and submit so that you can receive the blessing too. Because it's time to eat in this season. That's what I hear the Lord say. It's time to eat. But you won't be able to eat or drink or even sleep at night because you're disobedient and you know what you should be doing.
Amen.
God says that you know what you should be doing. And so let's get in alignment and let's receive the blessing and let's eat from the blessing, because there's a lot of people that need to look at you because you're going to even bless them. And so I give honor and I just thank God.
Okay. While the anointing is here, we want those that are struggling with that spirit of disobedience. It's a spirit, it's a mindset. And some of you have been overcome by Brother Kyle, Minister Prophet Kyle is gonna minister to you. You know who it is. You know if it's you. Nobody have to call you out. You know within your heart. You need to meet us at this altar. Amen. Come on. Some of you now, I don't have to call you. You know you've been disobedient. Come on to this altar. Hands, come with expectation. What you call it? Expectation. Hallelujah. There's more supposed to be in this altar. You heard God talk to you, speak to you. You know you hadn't lined up your everything that leadership asks you to do. And you say, I'm hearing God, you're not hearing God.
Wow. Amen. And so the first thing that I remember my apostles always say is that you have to have a repentant heart.
And so when you come to the altar, the first step to be, you have to first ask God to forgive you for being disobedient. And so I just want y'all to close your eyes and just repeat after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you will forgive me and totally destroy every spirit that has caused me to be disobedient and to be detoured and not submissive to your will. And Father, I love you, and I don't want anything to separate me from your will. And so forgive me this day. I'll do your will. I'll be submissive. I'll be obedient. Because I want the blessing. And say, Lord, endow me with your power. Endow me with your grace. And endow me with strength. To be able to be obedient and be submissive and endure this walk with an obedient heart in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
And that she will not be stumbled or detoured or moved in this season, but she shall be planted like a tree beside living water in the name of Jesus, that she will not be shaken or moved in Jesus' name. Obedience that has even caused cause a cycle of procrastination and even prolong the blessing in the name of Jesus. I prophetically proclaim that she will receive the blessing in this season in the name of Jesus, and that she will no longer be held back or prolonged, but the blessing is her portion in the name of Jesus. I prophesy the blessing is yours. I prophesy the blessing is yours in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the blessing is yours.
Thank you.
aside, and you're truly peculiar, is what I hear the Lord say. And he says that I've even invested in you many talents and gifts that are going to naturally bring forth wealth to you. And he says wealth is your portion, and the blessing is your portion, and you truly been called by God. And I can even see the prophetic mantle being awakened even the more. So in the name of Jesus, Father, as I lay my hands, I ask that you release the blessing in the name of Jesus, and let the fire begin to set ablaze upon her in the name of Jesus. Enemy in the name of Jesus.
So what he's gonna do, he's just gonna lay hands upon each one of you all. You just gotta just receive, okay? He's just gonna lay hands.